Burundi, in East Africa, is a former Belgian colony. So they are both French-speaking countries. But at the same, only men were speaking French. Then I took classes of Kirundi to be able to speak with the ladies. And I think that there is a difference, that African women are more expansive and they express the Kirundi colère.
Anger
they have. But in my experience, I saw that the Indian ladies, they keep more inside and they struggle with that. And I know, for instance, African poets writing in English or in French, and who were the voice of their sisters, able to share the suffering and also the joys of life. But I couldn't find for the moment Indian poetess who express their feelings.
About translating, now you have used something, some like some of the poetic devices like Ville through Tanton, Tony through all. Now it is an alliteration.
Yes,
now while translating, did you find a scope for alliteration or other poetic devices?
What page?
Page number
is 8.
C'est pour toi la question. Did you find
it? It is a poetic device. Will then talk story through one. Now, here of course in English you cannot have that alliteration there. You made it like other city reading. Now, is there any other place where you got this kind of scope?
Okay,
no, no,
when you
repeat a vowel or repeat a consonant, it gives a musicality. So here it has been done in French, like Vite and Tonitruan, ta. Now, did you find similar scope, not here, but some other places? Est-ce qu'on dit alliteration en français?
Alliteration, oui.
Alliteration. Ici, il y a une alliteration de la lettre T.
Non, est-ce que tu en as dans le texte?
Non, on ne peut pas traduire avec alliteration, je sais comment.
No, yeah, I tried as much as I could. What mattered more for me was to render an atmosphere, the heaviness of the poetry. For example, when people gather on the terrace to have an evening, you know, this mellow flappishness and the sourness of the speech. I really tried to find the right word to evoke this. It's more evocative.
Yeah, I know. The translation is very good, excellent translation. But I was wondering whether you got some opportunity in some other places.
No book, nothing, just like my
common sense.
I didn't even have an English-speaking person. I wish I had. But
your translation is extremely good. Very good.
Thank you.
So, do you have more questions or just comments or something you want to say? Because it's a heavy text and it's strong text. Do you want to share something else?
These poems are just extracts from the entire book of poetry you have written.
Yes.
So when will the entire book be launched?
When
will the entire book be launched?
When we will find a publisher.
A publisher.
You can publish on the internet. You don't need a publisher nowadays.
But the rest of the book is not translated. It's only in
But all the poems are related to city or your experiences over the years? All the poems of yours?
No, not about the city, mainly the others are, they are about nature, also the mountain,
Now you mentioned about that Nirbhaya case. There is a movie made by a foreigner called India's Daughter by Leslie Godwin. And that movie is banned in India. It's not to be, it was made on this movie. She was disturbed and she made a movie on that. But the public is not able to see the movie.
In India?
Yeah. It's been rather appreciated and very much in abroad, in Berlin and all that. But here it's not been available for public. India's Daughter by Leslie Godwin. Similar, she felt disturbed and she had a restless nights for that.
Lipstick under my phone.
That is another one.
It's currently
banned.
Banned. Because it speaks of Indian women's desire and the fantasies and breaking free from that suppressed social context. So it's not been publicized yet in India.